This is a follow-up to my video about macOS Monterey on an Apple MacBook Pro from mid-2009, a computer approaching 14 years old but still going strong. Most of the points from that video still stand, so if you want a better idea on what it's like to run such a new OS on this older computer, watch that video first. It's currently linked on the i on the top right. The heroes behind the OpenCore legacy patch have managed to port video acceleration for these older computers' graphics on macOS Ventura. So how well does it work? About as well as Monterey, but there are some things worthy of a new video. Did you know the built-in mouse and trackpad of older MacBooks run internally via USB 1.1? Maybe you didn't, but you most likely knew that USB 2.0 is backwards compatible with previous versions. Well, not anymore. Apple is well known for removing backwards compatibility, like classic apps on PowerPC, PowerPC apps on Intel, 32-bit apps on 64-bit, and eventually 64-bit Intel apps on Apple Silicon. But for now, the latest legacy thing that Apple has removed is support for USB 1, which wouldn't seem like a problem at all, but it was still fine for basic devices like a keyboard. So during the installation and the first time setup, you have to use an external USB mouse and keyboard. I had them on a USB hub since this Mac only has two USB ports. But what is that supposed to indicate? I know that's the Apple wireless mouse with the charging port at the bottom, but is the other thing an Apple keyboard or a trackpad? It looks more like those early MacBook Pros with the optical drive at the front. Anyway, the setup had an error at one point and asked for a startup disk, but restarting manually from the menu let it continue. As usual, it doesn't estimate the remaining time very well. It was stuck at less than 1 minute remaining for well over half an hour. Then, after painstakingly going through the terribly slow setup assistant, I could install the root patches, which for some reason weren't automatic like on Monterey. And now Ventura is working as well as it can on this computer. To improve performance and reduce some graphical glitches, I went to the system preferences, sorry, system settings is what they're called now, and turned off transparency. It doesn't look that bad. The system settings work fine, except for the Wi-Fi ones, which only appear blank. To set up Wi-Fi, you have to do it from the network settings, or from the status bar, after enabling its icon, which is gone, because some newer Macs have less space on the top bar now. Can't blame them too much, after all you do need a notch for the Face ID sensor. Oh wait, no Mac has Face ID yet. So should you install Ventura on an older Mac? Like I said in the previous video, the answer for most people is no. It may be interesting to try, and it's not totally unusable, but it's not good for serious use. Most Ventura features require newer hardware anyway. Some new Mac apps like iMovie don't work at all, even though they work fine on High Sierra or older. This newer macOS will probably run better on Macs with metal-capable graphics, so like 2012 or newer, but this one is older. You can tinker with older computers much more than the newest ones, but of course they are less powerful. Here's a new feature in Ventura, this app called Freeform. At first I thought, wow, finally macOS comes with a paint app, just like Windows did since version 1.0? But no, it's some kind of shared scrapbook, where you or other people can put shapes and text boxes and pictures and stuff. The scribble on the icon implies you can draw on it, but I haven't found a way to do that. Either it can't, or it requires newer hardware too. This 2009 Mac is still decent for simple computing tasks in 2023. But if you want macOS, you should stick with El Capitan or High Sierra on it. They're much faster on this older hardware. Of course, if you have a newer Mac that officially supports a newer OS, like Catalina or Big Sur or Monterey, then you should install that newer version. On this Core 2 Duo computer, other recent operating systems like Windows 10, Windows 11, and new Linux distributions perform much better than macOS Ventura, but they're not perfect either. That could be an idea for a future video, maybe. If I've made that video, you should see it linked on screen right now. Otherwise, you'll see a random video suggestion. Thank you for watching.